Thank you. Chose the piano in case you, not just in case you're going into the showroom and saying, oh, I think we'll have that one. It is a case of there's certain things that one looks for. A lot of the techniques and the styles you've already heard, but in terms of the technique, what the piano can do, if you think of, for example, a pure articulation that you get in some Baroque music, for example, even without use of the pedal, for example. Sounded and the clarity and the definition of the sound, or if you think of the responsiveness of the keys, if you're playing rapid repeated notes, for example. It really is incredibly easy on the touch, and yet there's a certain springiness to the action as well. Then if you think of how to make the piano sing. What is it about the Steinway? You play a Steinway and you play a chord and you think, ah, Steinway. there are, of course, other brands available. but we're not going to mention any of them. Just as a former teacher of mine used to do a very long drive from London to Yorkshire, and he said that he used to play on in his car CDs of the Vaughan Williams symphonies in a vain attempt to understand why that is defined as being English in style. And I think the same thing with the Steinway, there is a certain indefinable element. However, the definable part is the mechanism and the workmanship that goes into it. There's such care, and nothing is mass-produced. On every floor of the five-story building that we went to, there were experts working on one particular aspect of the piano. Some working on keys, some on the hammers, some on the felt, some on the strings themselves, some on the every aspect. And you can feel that. It's that responsiveness and the warm glow. Now, coming back to what I was going to say about how to make the piano sing. So if you think of, say, Mozart, for example, a slow movement of the D major sonata. So in romantic music, if I think of Schumann, I'm trying to think of how response. What if you think of something? If in your imagination you have a certain sound that you want to achieve, invariably this piano will do it. So, for example, in as a little snippet of Schumann from Carnival, his one of his great cycles. So, if you start, you think passionate. Thank you. that's coming across. I mean, it's in my imagination, it seems to think it's okay. Now, then you have all of the, then you think about concerto playing, which is a playing where you play a deep into the key. So if you're thinking this, that sort of thing, or deep into the key, but yet the piano retains its bloom of sound. There's no harshness, and another part of that is to do with technique as well, but the piano enables you to do that. Other styles too, of course, that haven't been covered, ragtime. Mephisto was number one. One of his, Liszt was an ultimate, quite a showman. He was very, very inspired by the violinist Paganini, who was the great virtuoso violinist of his day, and he took the world by storm. Liszt heard him, and then he thought, this is fantastic, but how can I make the piano sound like this? And so therefore, he brought into literally devilish techniques, because the story behind Mephisto Waltz is that the devil, or Mephistopheles, aka the devil, basically he plays his violin. So you hear that at the beginning, it sounds like a violin tuning up. And then what he does, he goes to the village inn, which is why this is called Dance in the Village Inn, is the subtitle. And he basically plays his violin, and he basically, it's like a sort of a Pied Piper effect, where the audience, or rather the people there, they are transfixed by the violin, and they follow him while as he plays this devilish waltz-like tune. Nothing like the minute waltz. This is the minute waltz with edge. So he basically they go along with him, and they dance with him. Then he takes them to the woods, and then the music becomes more expressive. And he's trying to, because after all, it is the devil. He is trying to tempt them to be part of his mindset. And so you hear all of the seductiveness of the music in the middle section. Now, however, if you do agree to the promises that the devil promises you, it doesn't end well. And so, therefore, at the end, when the devil finds that he's not, his seductive methods in music are not working, then it turns a little bit nasty, and there's an edge to that. And then all of a sudden you feel that the people are feeling trapped, and so on. But then there's a massive explosion, and then you hear the nightingale sing, everything's going to be okay, and there's one final twist at the end. So this is Mephisto Waltz from Liszt. Thank you.
Thank you.